Welcome to the lecture on structural analysis. So in the last few lectures we have been discussing about plastic analysis of structures. Last class we have done two problems on continuous beams. Now in this lecture we will take up the analysis of portal frames. So in the case of portal frames, you will have the mechanisms, namely beam mechanism, sometimes column mechanism, sway mechanism or panel mechanism, and a combination, namely combined mechanism or composite mechanism. So the types of independent and combined mechanism already we have discussed at the beginning. Now under portal frames we will start from a numerical example. So find out the fully plastic moment for the frame shown in the figure. Now this is an asymmetrical frame. The left side column is 9 meters. So this is 6 meters, this is 6 meters. Now both ends are hinged. The bottom ends of the both columns are hinged. So this is the portal frame which you have to analyze. Now first you have to find out the degree of static indeterminacy of the frame. The static indeterminacy, we use the notation R. R equal to number of closed loops into 3 minus number of releases. Number of releases is equal to 1. Number of closed loop is 1 into 3 minus number of releases. A is hinged, therefore it is free to rotate. F is also hinged, it is also free to rotate. So they cannot move in the horizontal direction or vertical direction, they can only rotate. So here you got one release, namely it is free to rotate, this is also free to rotate, therefore there are two releases. So 1 into 3 minus number of is equal to releases is equal to 1. So the structure is statically indeterminate to 1 degree. Right. Now next is number of possible plastic hinges. Number of possible plastic hinges. So this is a structural hinge. So right. Now coming to this, under this concentrated load you have a possibility for a plastic hinge. Now at this junction where the two members meet, that is one location where there will be a plastic hinge. Under this load a plastic hinge. At this junction where the column and beam meet, we have a plastic hinge. So this is a structural hinge. So we have to concentrate only on number of plastic hinges. So coming to plastic hinges, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So n equal to 4. N equal to 4. Number of possible plastic hinges is equal to 4. Now the number of independent mechanisms, number of independent mechanisms is equal to n minus r. N equal to 4 minus 1 equal to 3. There are 3 possible independent mechanisms. So they are, one is the beam mechanism for this beam, the other one is for this column there will be a mechanism, then there will be a sway mechanism. So these are the 3 independent mechanisms. Then we have the combined mechanism or composite mechanism. Right. Now coming to mechanism 1, first is beam. Mechanism. Now this is of a 6 meter span, so there is a central load 20 kilonewton. This is 3 meters, this is 3 meters. So the mechanism, you will have a plastic hinge here, you will have a plastic hinge here. And then under the load you will have the third hinge, namely this is the third plastic hinge. So this is the mechanism. This is the mechanism. MP is uniform. MP is uniform throughout. So this is a theta. So since this is 3 meters, this is also 3 meters, this is also theta. Also theta. Now when you extend this, you know, this is 2 theta. So already we have discussed under beam mechanism elaborately. Therefore, now you can understand what is the meaning of the 2 theta. So 2 theta. So 2 theta. Then coming to this. So this value will be, this is 3 meters, this is theta, therefore this is 3 theta. Right. Now coming to the moment, this is MP, this is MP, this is also MP. MP, MP, MP. That's about the mechanism. We have marked all the hinges, all the rotations, all the required displacements, everything you have marked. So the mechanism, you have to mark all the details first. So that will make your calculations simple, right? So that is very important, right? Now coming to the calculations, external work done. External work done, W E equal to, this is the load, this is the only load, 20 kilonewton. This displacement is 3 theta. So 20 into 3 theta is the external work done. Load is 20, displacement is 3 theta, therefore it is 60 into theta. That is the external work done. External work done. Now coming to internal work done. Internal work done, W I equal to, I equal to, so here it is MP, so MP into theta plus MP into 2 theta plus MP into theta, so MP into theta at the left support plus MP into 2 theta at the center plus MP into theta, that is equal to 4 MP theta, that is equal to 4 MP theta. So equating external work done and internal, equate WE equal to WI gives, equating the external and internal works. So WE equal to WI gives 60 theta equal to 4 MP theta. 4 MP theta. So theta will get cancelled. So MP equal to 60 by 4. So MP equal to 15 kilonewton meter. This is one value. This is by mechanism 1, MP equal to 15 kilonewton meter. So this is by beam mechanism, right? So next we will take up the column mechanism. The column mechanism, we will consider ABC. We will consider ABC. So next is that of so we know column mechanism is another beam mechanism. Column mechanism, there is a load at the at a distance of 6 meter from the end A. So that will cause a mechanism. Therefore, this is the column. This is a column. This column is subjected to a lateral load of 20 kilonewton. This distance is 6 meters. 6 meters. 6 meters. So this is 3 meters. Right. Now here, you will have, this is a structural hinge. At the bottom it is hinged, structural hinge. So here at this junction you will have a plastic hinge. Plastic hinge. So under this load, here you will have a plastic hinge. So here you will have a plastic hinge. And this is structural hinge. So this is the mechanism. This is the mechanism. Now, if you take this as theta, theta. Now this value will be, this value will be 6 meters, this is theta. So 6 meters into theta, that is equal to 6 theta. That is equal to 6 theta. Now coming to the hinge at the center. Now here, if you extend this line, this will be theta plus theta 1, because this is theta 1. Theta 1, because this is 6 meters, this is 3 meters, they cannot be same, they cannot be same, therefore this is theta 1, theta 1. So to find out the value of theta, you know, this ordinate from the bottom, it is 6 into theta, that is 6 theta, 6 theta. When it is measured from the top, this is 3 meters, this is theta 1, so this ordinate is also equal to 3 theta 1. 3 theta. Therefore, theta 1 equal to 6 theta by 3, or theta 1 equal to 2 theta. Theta 1 equal to 2 theta. Theta 1 equal to 2 theta. Right. Now, coming to theta plus theta 1. Theta plus theta 1 equal to theta plus 2 theta equal to 3 theta. 3 theta. Therefore, this value equal to 2 theta. Now this value equal to 3 theta. And here also it is MP. MP is uniform. MP. And here at this hinge it is MP. And here it is 0. It is a structural hinge. I think we have marked all the required details. So now our calculation will be simple. External work done. External work done. WE equal to, this load is 20 into 6 theta. 20 into 6 theta. So 20 is the load. The displacement is 6 theta. That is equal to 120 theta. 120 theta. That is external work done. Internal work done. WI equal to, now here it is 0, 0 into theta. So MP is 0 here. So here MP into the rotation is 3 theta, rotation is 3 theta, plus MP here into 2 theta. Therefore, it is 0 into theta at the bottom. So this will get cancelled. So MP into 2 theta plus MP into theta, that is equal to 3 MP theta. 3 MP theta. That is the internal work done. Now, external work done equal to internal work done gives, external work done is 120 into theta, that is equal to, internal work done is equal to 3 MP into theta. So theta and theta will get cancelled. Will get cancelled. So that will give you MP equal to 120 by 3. MP equal to. So MP equal to 120 by 3 equal to 40. Therefore, MP equal to, we'll write here, MP equal to 40. 120 by 3 equal to 40 kilonewton meter. So this is by mechanism 2. By mechanism 2, MP equal to 40 kilonewton meter. So one is something wrong. Something wrong. MP into 3 theta. Sorry. There is a correction. This is MP into 3 theta. MP into this we have written as 2 theta. This is not correct. So MP into 3 theta. So here it is MP into 3 theta. And here it is MP into 2 theta. Therefore, this is 2 theta. MP into 2 theta. Therefore, this will become 5 MP theta. There is a correction. So, 5 MP theta. One is MP into 3 theta plus MP into 2 theta. Therefore, that is 5 MP theta. Therefore, this value is 5 MP theta. 5 MP theta, 5 MP theta. Therefore, this will become 5. This will become 5. So, 120 by 5 equal to, 120 by 5 equal to 24. 24. Therefore, this is not 40, this is 24 kilonewton meter. So, that is the corrected value. So, correct value is 24 kilonewton meter. So, that's about mechanism 2. Mechanism 2. So we have three independent mechanisms. We have completed two independent mechanisms. So next one is sway mechanism or panel mechanism. Sway mechanism or panel mechanism. Sway, or you can say panel. Panel mechanism or sway mechanism. Panel mechanism or sway mechanism, right. Now this is the frame. So this is the frame, 9 meters, 6 meters, 6 meters, right. So here it is hinged, here also it is hinged. Now there is a load, 20 here, there is a central load, here also there is a load of 20 kilonewton. This is 3 meters, 3 meters, this is 6 meters, here it is 3 meters, this is 6, totally 9 meters, 9 meters. Now, we are going to take up the panel mechanism. Panel mechanism, there will be only sway. So there will be no mechanism in the beam now. We are discussing about independent mechanisms. So later, under combined mechanism or composite mechanism, we will take up the combination of sway mechanism and beam mechanism. Right? Beam mechanism. So now we are considering only sway. Right. Sway means, so this column will sway like this. Will sway like this. So this is a structural hinge, so this will undergo a rotation of theta. Now here, originally it is a right angle, therefore this is actually more than 90 degrees, more than 90 degrees. Therefore here you need a hinge for the rotation, for making the angle more than 90 degrees. Therefore this is the, and here you are going to have it like this. So, without a plastic hinge here, there cannot be a rotation, because now this has become less than 80 degrees. Less than 80 degrees. Therefore, the rotation here will not be possible without a hinge. Now, here already it is a structural hinge. Structural hinge. Right. So, this is what is the panel mechanism or sway mechanism. Now, this value, this is 9 meters. This is a theta, 9 theta. So this is 9 into theta or theta, 9 into theta. So when this is 9 into theta, the beam is axially rigid. It will not undergo any axial deformation. Therefore, when this is 9 theta, this will also be equal to 9 theta, because there is no axial deformation in the beam. So that is also 9 theta. 9 theta. Now, when this is 9 theta, this is 9 meters height of column, this is 6 meters height column, therefore, this value will be theta 1. Therefore, with respect to vertical, this value will also be theta 1. Theta 1. Now, this theta 1 equal to 9 theta by the height of the column. Theta 1 equal to 9 theta by 6. 9 theta by 6. 9 by 6 equal to 1.5 theta. 9 by 6 equal to 1.5 theta. Therefore, here this is also equal to 1.5 theta. 1.5 theta. Right. Now, with respect to vertical, originally it was a right angle. Now, with respect to vertical, the rotation undergone by this joint, by this hinge is equal to theta. Because this is theta, therefore this is also theta. This is vertical, this is vertical. So, when this angle is theta, this is also equal to theta. So, this hinge undergoes a rotation of theta. Because originally it was a right angle, now it has become more than 90. So, by theta, therefore 90 into theta. So, that angles you have to clearly understand for, right. Now, external work done. W E equal to, now this 20 into this displacement. Now, this displacement here equal to 6 into theta. 6 into theta. So, 20 into 6 theta, 20 into 6 theta, that is in the column, plus this beam, we are not allowing any mechanism now. So, this is 20 into 0, that's all. 20 into 0. Forget about this. 20 into 0. That is equal to 20 into 6 equal to 120 theta. 120 theta. Right. Internal work done. W I equal to, so here it is 0 into theta. 0 into theta plus, now here it is MP, it has undergone a rotation of theta. Originally it was 90 degrees, now 90 plus theta, that theta equal to, of course, that is a rotation, that is a rotation. Therefore, this 90 degrees angle has increased by theta. So, the rotation is only theta. Therefore, it is MP, the plastic moment capacity is MP into theta plus, plus. Now, here this is MP. All plastic moment capacity is MP, which is uniform throughout the frame. So, here also it is MP, MP, here it is MP, MP into the rotation is theta 1. Theta 1 equal to 1.5 theta. Theta 1 equal to 1 point, because originally it was a right angle. Right angle. This has diminished by theta 1. The change is theta 1. Theta 1 equal to 1.5 theta. Because of this hinge, the rotation is possible. The rotation is theta 1. Theta 1 equal to 1.5 theta. So, MP into 1.5 theta. Plus, plus. So, here it is a structural hinge. Structural hinge. Therefore, 0 into theta 1. So, forget about this. Forget about this. That is for completion. We are just writing all the terms. Right. MP into theta plus MP into 1.5 theta equal to 2.5 MP into theta. 2.5 MP into theta. Right. Now, W E equating the external and internal works. W E equal to W I gives external work done is 120 into theta, internal work done is equal to 2.5 MP theta. Therefore, 120 into theta equal to 2.5 MP into theta. So, theta will get cancelled. So, MP equal to 120 divided by 2.5. So, MP equal to, so 120 by 2.5 equal to 48. Therefore, MP equal to 48 kilonewton meter by the third mechanism, namely the panel mechanism or sway mechanism, that gives you 48 kilonewton meter. So we have completed all the three independent mechanisms, namely B mechanism, column mechanism, and panel mechanism or sway mechanism. Now we will take up the combined mechanism. Combined mechanism or composite mechanism. Combined or composite. Composite mechanism, which will be a combination of sway mechanism and B mechanism. Combined mechanism or composite mechanism, which will be a combination of B mechanism and sway mechanism. Right. Now, this is the original frame. Six meters. So this is a structural hinge. This is a structural hinge. There is a lateral load of 20 kilonewton at 6 meters from the bottom. 6 meters. This is 3 meters. 3 meters. And this is again 6 meters, 20 kilonewton three meters. That's about the dimensions. Now we are going to combine the sway mechanism and the B mechanism, right? So we will take this as a deformed shape of the column. Now here this is 90 degrees, so we want, actually the structure is statically indeterminate to 1 degree only, statically indeterminate 1 degree. Therefore one hinge is needed for the formation of a statically determinate structure, then plus one hinge is needed for converting it as a mechanism. So in this case we have two structural hinges. We had two plastic hinges, 1 plus 1, two plastic hinges. So degree of redundancy plus one hinge for the mechanism. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 hinges. So in the combined mechanism also we need only 2 hinges, because already there are two structural hinges. The degree of redundancy is 1. Therefore, 1 plus 1 hinge. Now, that one hinge, you just avoid here. You just avoid here. Therefore, when you are not allowing any hinge here, this 90 degrees angle will be maintained. 90. So, actually, it is little more, but still, this is 90 degrees. For marking the details clearly, just I given more angle, but actually it will be 90 degrees only. It will be only 90 degrees. For convenience in marking the details, just given more value of theta here. So when this is theta, when this is 90 degrees, when in the absence of a hinge here, when this is also 90 degrees, this value will be theta. This value will be theta. Theta, right? Theta. Right. Now, we will have a hinge here. Of course, this is of a small value. This deformation is small. Therefore, sometimes you will be tempted to think this is 3 meters. So, this is 9 theta. They are small deformations. You can ignore. So 3 theta. So in the sketch you need not bother much about that 9 theta, whether it is 3 minus 9 theta, don't bother about those values. These are small values. Now when the frame moves, this load also will correspondingly move. So this is the deformation under the load. So this will be 3 meters only. This will be 3 meters only. Therefore when this is theta, this deformation will be 3 into theta, right. Now here at this point, when this is theta, when this is 6 meters, this will be a 6 into theta. Right. Now, this is 3 meters, this is 3 meters, therefore this will also be theta. And when this is theta and this is theta, when you extend this line, this will be 2 theta. Theta plus theta equal to 2 theta. There is what that we have clearly discussed in the case of beams. I think there will be no doubt in that 2 theta. So 2 theta. Now, when this is 9 into theta, this deformation will also be 9 into theta, because there is no axial deformation. So at the top of this column, when this is 9 theta, this will also be equal to 9 theta, because we are not assuming any axial deformation in the beam. Right. Now, 9 theta. Now, this will become like this. So, this value equal to theta 1. Therefore, with respect to vertical, this is also equal to theta 1. Now, theta 1 is 9 theta by the height of the column. So, theta 1 equal to 9 theta by the height of the column. Height of the column is 6 meters. So, theta 1, 9 theta by, 1.5 theta equal to 1.5 theta. So, this is equal to 1.5 theta. This is also equal to 1.5 theta. Right. Now, I think we have marked all the details that are needed for the calculations. External work done. WE equal to, so this 20 into 6 theta, this is because of the displacement of the column from the vertical. Now it is a combination of sway mechanism and the beam mechanism. Now in the beam mechanism, the beam undergoes a downward displacement of 3 into theta. Therefore, 20 into 3 theta will be the work done here because of this load, 20 into 3 theta. So, plus 20 into 3 theta, because it was not there in the earlier case, because here we are not allowed the beam to undergo the deformation. We have considered only sway, independent mechanism. Now it is a combined mechanism, combining sway and the beam mechanism. So that value equal to 20 into 6 theta. So 20 into 6, 120. 20 into 3, 60. That is equal to 180 theta. That is the external work done. Internal work done equal to internal. So here it is 0 into theta plus. Now here there is no plastic hinge. So we assumed that plastic hinges here and here. We need only 1 plus 1, 2 hinges. Therefore, here the plastic moment is MP. So, MP into 2 theta plus MP into 2 theta plus. At this point, originally it was a right angle. Now, at this hinge, this has undergone a rotation of theta, and this column has undergone a rotation of 1.5 theta. So, the originally right angle has diminished by 1 theta in the beam, 1.5 theta in the column. So, the total rotation is theta plus 1.5 theta. This is MP here. MP is the moment. This is the plastic hinge. Because of this plastic hinge, this horizontal beam has rotated through theta. This vertical column has rotated through 1.5 theta. Therefore, this value will be 90 minus theta minus 1.5 theta. Therefore, the rotation is theta plus 1.5 theta. That is another important point to be noted. Therefore, here it is MP, theta in the beam plus 1.5 theta in the column. that is at the joint, plus here, here 0 into 1.5 theta, theta. So you can forget about this, you can forget about this. So that is equal to MP into 2 theta plus MP into 2.5 theta. So 2, that is equal to 4.5 MP, 4.5 MP into theta. Therefore, equating the external WE equal to WI, equating the external and internal work gives 180 theta, 180 into theta. This is the external work done. External work done is 180 into theta. This is the internal work done, WI. So 180 into theta equal to 4.5 MP into theta, 4. So this will get cancelled. So MP equal to 180 by 4.5. Now 180 by 4.5 equal to 40. 180 by is equal to 40. So MP equal to 40 kilonewton meter. So the fourth value, MP equal to 40 kilonewton meter. This is by the combined mechanism. So this is by the panel mechanism, beam mechanism, column mechanism, panel mechanism, and the combined mechanism. Therefore, from 1 to 4, you have to find out the value MP. We have discussed already MP. You have to find out the highest value. You are going to design the structure for MP. If it is collapse load, you have to find out what is the minimum load at which it will fail. So we have to find out what is the collapse load and what is the mechanism by which the structure will fail. Now here, when you find out MP, what is the maximum moment for which you have to design the structure? So out of all the four possible mechanisms, we find the highest value is 48. Highest value is 48. Therefore, you have to design the frame for a plastic moment capacity of 48. 48 is the highest value, 48 kilonewton meter. This value is the highest, because this is the moment for which you are going to design the frame. 48 kilonewton meter is the value. That is how you have to analyze the portal frame. Now we will take up the next problem. Next problem is another portal frame. Fixed here. Fixed here. There is a load at this joint, whose value equal to 2.25 W. Now here it is 4W. This distance equal to 2.25 meters. This distance is 3.75 meters. The height of this column is 6 meters. So ABCD, ABCD. The plastic moment capacity of this beam, this column is MP. For this beam, it is 3 MP. And here it is 2 MP. 2 MP. 2 MP, 6 meters, ABCD. 4W, 2.25, 3.75, 2.25. So you'll have to find out the value. Find out the value of W at collapse. Find out the value of W at collapse. Now coming to the analysis of this structure. This structure is statically indeterminate to R equal to 1 into 3, that is one closed loop into 3 minus number of releases. So here A is fixed, D is also fixed, therefore they cannot undergo any displacement or rotation. Therefore the number of release equal to 0, therefore this is equal to, so this structure, as we know, it is statically indeterminate to 3 degrees. Right. Number of possible plastic hinges, n equal to. So here at this fixed end, we'll have a plastic hinge. And here at this junction, we'll have a plastic hinge 2. Here there is a plastic hinge 3. And here there is one plastic hinge 4. And from at the point D, we'll have a plastic hinge 5. So therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Therefore, number of plastic hinges are 5. Therefore, n stands for the number of independent mechanisms. So, number of independent mechanisms is equal to number of possible plastic hinges minus the degree of redundancy. That is 5 minus 3 equal to 2. So, 2 independent mechanisms. So here one will be the B mechanism, the other will be the sway mechanism. So they are the 2 independent mechanisms. The third one is a combined mechanism, right? Now let us consider the B mechanism first. B mechanism. B mechanism. Now coming to B mechanism, this is the beam of 6 meters, 2.25 plus 3.75 is 6 meters. So here there is a load, 2.25, there is a load of 4W. We are assuming only beam mechanism, this will not cause any sway now. Therefore, you will have a plastic hinge here, and under the load you will have a plastic hinge. So this is the third hinge. So this is your mechanism. So this distance is 2.25 meters. This is 3.75 meters. Right. So now we need not bother about this horizontal load because we are assuming only the beam mechanism. Right. So this is theta. This is theta. Now this displacement is here, this value 2.25 into theta, therefore it is 2.25 into theta. Now coming to the other right hand side, this is theta 1, because this is 2.25, this is 3.75, they cannot be same, theta 1. Now coming to this ordinate, when it is measured from left, it is 2.25 into theta, 2.25
into theta.
When it is measured from right, it is 3.75 into theta 1. 3.75 into theta 1 when it is measured from the right. The same ordinate, 2.25 into theta or 3.75 into theta 1. Right. Therefore, theta 1 equal to 2.25 theta by 3.75 or theta 1 equal to 0.6 theta. Theta 1 equal to 0.6 theta. Theta 1 equal to 0.6 theta. Therefore, this value is equal to 0.6 theta. Now, here, when you extend this line, this value will be theta plus theta 1. That is equal to theta plus 0.6 theta. That is equal to 1.6 theta. Theta plus theta 1 equal to 1.6 theta. 1.6 theta. Right. There is only one load, 4W, which undergoes a displacement 2.25 theta. Now, coming to the plastic moment. Now, here it is MP. Here it is 3MP. At this junction, the plastic hinge will form at the least value of the moment. So, you'll have plastic hinge in the column as well as in the beam. In the column, the plastic hinge forms when M equal to MP. In the beam, the plastic hinge forms when M equal to 3MP. Therefore, at the junction, at the column, the hinge will form earlier when M equal to MP. Therefore, at this point where the two members meet, the hinge will form at the least value, namely MP, not 3MP. Right. Coming to this beam, it is 3MP. Therefore, this value equal to 3MP. This value equal to 3MP. 3MP, right? Now, this value here, this is 3MP, this is 2MP. At this junction, the hinge will form at the least moment. That least moment is 2MP here. Least value is 2MP here, right? Now, that is about the details. I think the details are clear. Right. Now, external work done. External work done. W E equal to 4W into 2.25 theta. 4W into 2.25 theta. So, 4W into 2.25 theta equal to 9 theta. Equal 9W theta. 9W theta. So, W I equal to. So, here MP into theta. So, MP into theta plus here 3MP into 1.6 theta plus 3MP into 1.6 theta plus now here 2MP into 0.6 theta plus 2MP into 0.6 theta. So, this will be equal to sum equal to 7MP theta. 7MP into theta. So, equating the external and internal work, WE equal to WI gives 9W theta equal to 7MP theta. Theta will get cancelled. So, W equal to, you are asked to find out the value of W at collapse. So, WC equal to 7 by 9 MP. So, that value equal to 0.78 MP. So, WC equal to 0.78 MP. So, this is 1. So, WC equal to 0.78 MP is by mechanism 1, first value, right. So, that is about the B mechanism. Next, equal to, that is beam mechanism. Next is a sway mechanism. Sway mechanism or panel mechanism. Sway mechanism or panel mechanism. Right. Now this is the frame. 3 meters. This is 6 meters. This is 6 meters. Here it is fixed. Here it is fixed. So it is indeterminate to 3 degrees. The structure is indeterminate 3 degrees. So you want 3 plus 1. There are 4 hinges. So we need 4 hinges for the formation of a mechanism, namely panel mechanism. So this is a fixed end. So you need a hinge here. A hinge here. Then it is like this. So undergoes a rotation of theta here. So this value is theta. When this is theta, this value will be, this is 3 meters. Therefore, this is 3 into theta. 3 into theta, right. Now, here, you are not combining the beam mechanism. So, when this is 3 theta, this will also be equal to 3 theta. We are not considering the axial deformation. This is also 3 theta. When this is 3 theta, this is also 3 theta. Right. Now, you find that this will become like this, like this. Now, this is 90 degrees. This is more than 90 degrees. Therefore, you need a hinge for its rotation. And here, this is 90 degrees. Here it is less than 90 degrees. So, you will have a plastic hinge here also, allowing the rotation. And here it is a fixed end. Therefore, you need a plastic hinge, plastic, without which a rotation is not possible. Right. When this is theta, this is 3 theta. So with respect to vertical, this is also equal to theta. Originally it was 90 degrees. It is now 90 plus theta. Now, when this is 3 theta, this value is theta 1. Theta 1 equal to 3 theta by 6. Theta 1 equal to 3 theta by 6. That is equal to 0.5 theta. Now, this 90 degrees angle has diminished by theta 1. Theta 1 is also equal to 0.5 theta. Right. Now, coming to the load, here it is 2.25 W. Here it is 2.25 W. Now, here there is a load 4 W. Since it is a panel mechanism, we are not combining the beam deformation. Therefore, 4W into 0, that's all. I think we have marked all the data. Now, external work done is equal to 2.25 into 3 theta. 2.25 is the load into 3 theta. 2.25 W into 3 theta plus 4W into 0 plus 4W into 0. Therefore, this you can forget about. 2.25 into 3 theta will be equal to 6.75 W theta. This is equal to 6.75 W theta. Internal work done equal to here, this is MP for this column. This is MP. So here it is MP. Now here at this junction, the least of these two values. So here also it is MP. At this junction, this is 3 MP, this is 2 MP, least value is 2 MP. The hinge at the junction will form at the least value or 2 MP. So here also it is 2 MP, because for the column the plastic moment capacity is MP. Therefore, MP into theta, MP into theta plus here MP into theta, MP into theta, MP into this hinge also undergoes a rotation of theta. Now here 2 MP into 0.5 theta, 2 MP into 0.5 theta plus here also 2mp into 0.5 theta. 2mp into 0.5 theta. So mp into theta plus mp into theta plus 2 into 0.5, again mp into theta plus 2 into 0.5, again mp into theta, that is equal to 4mp theta. Therefore, equating the external and internal works, WE equal to WI gives 6.75 W theta equal to 4mp theta. So, theta and theta will get cancelled. Therefore, W equal to 4mp by 6.75. So, 4mp by 6.75 equal to 0.593 mp, 0.593 mp. So this is the second value. So therefore the second value WC equal to 0.593 mp. So this is by the second mechanism. We know that there are only two independent mechanisms. The two independent mechanisms are, one is B mechanism, the other one is the sway mechanism that we have considered. Now we'll have to combine the two, combination mechanism or composite mechanism. So we'll take up the combined mechanism or composite mechanism. Now so the frame is like this. This is 3 meters. This is 6 meters. This is again 6 meters. So here it is fixed. Here also it is fixed. We are going to combine the, we need only 2 hinges for the mechanism to form. We need only 4 hinges. We need 4 hinges. Sorry, this is 4 hinges. So 3 is the degree of redundancy. So we need 4 hinges. So obviously one hinge will be at the fixed support, another hinge will be at this fixed support. 2 hinges are over. Third hinge. So when you are going to combine the beam mechanism and the panel mechanism, let this rotation be a theta. Now we are going to combine the beam mechanism. Therefore, when this is 90 degrees, we will just maintain the same angle. So this angle, of course, it looks like less than 90 degrees, but actually this is 90 degrees because we are not allowing any rotation. Thus 90 degrees angle will be maintained. And plus, so there is no plastic hinge here. So here you assume the third hinge, and here you assume the fourth hinge. All right. When you assume the 4 hinges like that, so this will be theta 1. Therefore, with the vertical, because originally it was vertical like this, so this value is theta 1. Not theta 1, theta 1 already we used. We will use theta 2. I will tell you why that is theta 2. Right. Now, here, when this is theta, this is 90 degrees, this is also 90 degrees. Therefore, this value will be theta. Now, this distance is a 2.25 meters up to this. Here there is a point load. At 2.25 meters, on the left hand support, there is a load of 4W. This is 4W. Plus, there is another load here. Another load is a 2.25 W, right? Now, this value will be, this will be 2.25 into theta. 2.25 into theta. 2.25. Now, this is theta 1. Theta 1. Already we have calculated 2.25 into theta. From the right hand side, it is 3.75 into theta 1. So, here this is 3.75 meters from the right hand side. Therefore, 3.75 into theta 1. Therefore, theta 1 already we calculated 2.25 theta by 3.75. So, that is equal to 0.6 theta. 0.6. So, theta 1 equal to 0.6 theta. Already we have calculated this. When you have done the B mechanism, you have done this. Therefore, this value equal to 0.6 theta. Now, when you extend this line, this is theta plus theta 1 equal to theta plus 1.6 theta, 0.6 theta. 0.6 theta, that is equal to 1.6 theta. 1.6 theta. Because we have used theta 1 here, we have used theta 2 here. Now, when this deformation here is 3 into theta, this is equal to 3 into theta equal to 3 theta. When this is 3 theta, this is 3 theta, this will also be equal to 3 theta. This will also be equal to 3 theta, because we are not assuming any axial deformation in the member, 3 theta. Therefore, when that is 3 theta, 3 theta by the height of the column will give you theta 2. So, theta 2 equal to say 3 theta by 6. 3 theta by 6 equal to 0.5 theta. 0.5 theta. Therefore, this is also equal to 0.5 theta. 0.5 theta. That is about the hinges and their rotation. Coming to the moments, here it is MP, at this junction it is MP, because the least between these two MP. So here it is MP and here it is MP. Of course, here it is not necessary because there is no hinging here. Now here it is 3 MP at this point. Now at this junction, out of these two, the least value is 2 MP. Least value is 2 MP. 2 MP, and this is also 2 MP. 2 MP. Now, external work done. External work done. This is combined mechanism or composite mechanism. Composite. Composite mechanism or combined mechanism. Now, WE equal to 2.25 W into 3 theta. 2.25 W into 3 theta plus that 4 W. 4 W into it is 2.25 theta. That is the external work done. External work done is equal to 15.75 W theta. 15.75 W theta. WI equal to, you will not have any doubt, I think. Now, W internal equal to MP into theta here. MP into theta plus at this point 3 MP into 1.6 theta. 3 MP into 1.6 theta plus the most important point is this junction. This junction 2 MP into, with respect to this horizontal, this has undergone theta 1. Theta 1 equal to 0.6 theta. For the beam, it is 0.6 theta plus for the column, it is 0.5 theta. 0.5 theta. Because originally it was right angle, this has undergone a rotation of theta 1. This has undergone a rotation of theta 2. So theta 1, theta 2, that is the total rotation. Total rotation is equal to theta 1, which is equal to 0.6 theta. For the column, it is 0.5. This is a very important point. Very important point. Plus, at the bottom, it is 2 mp into theta 1. Theta 1 equal to 0.5 theta. 2 mp into 0.5 theta. That is here, 2 mp into 0.5 theta. So, that is about the internal work. Internal work equal to 9 mp theta. So, this is equal to 9 mp theta. So, WE equal to WI gives, so 15.75 W theta equal to 9 mp theta. So, theta will get cancelled. So, WC equal to 9 by 15.75 equal to 0.571 mp. This is your third value. So, WC equal to 0.571 mp. So, this is equal to 3. That is by the combined mechanism or composite mechanism. Therefore, you have analyzed the beam mechanism, panel mechanism, and the combined mechanism or composite mechanism. So, comparing the three values, 1, 2, and 3, the collapse load, WC equal to, the least value is 0.571 mp. So, you have to find out the collapse load. Collapse load will be the least value. That is, what is the minimum load at which it will fail? So, that is by combined. Therefore, the frame will fail by combined mechanism or composite mechanism. The frame will fail by the composite mechanism. So, that is why you have to analyze. So, in one case, we have got the MP, which is the highest value. The other case, we have got the collapse load, which is the least value. Right? So, that's all for the day. Thank you for listening. Thank you.